Michael Thames has made an incredibly beautiful instrument. It's a copy of the 1868 Torres FE-17, which has a unique history to it, in that Francisco Tárrega went to visit Torres and was looking at some guitars to purchase. But when Torres heard him play, Torres went to the back room to pull out this guitar, or the guitar that this is modeled on, which you can see has remarkable maple and beautiful inlay, and the characteristic tornavas, which is a feature of many Torres guitars of the epoch, and it has a rich, lush, beautiful sound. It's powerful, but its power is not at the expense ever of the timbre, which is one of the most remarkably beautiful guitar timbres I've ever heard. This opening of the second movement of the Torres Sonata just sounds stunning on the instrument. Torres played this guitar for approximately 20 years of his life until he more or less wore it out. They're characterized by pretty thin tops, made of spruce, clearly. But as many guitars were made in the 19th century, the back and sides of beautiful bird's eye maple. And then also, this issue of it being a slightly smaller body size, which for a person of my build, which is approximately 5'7", 160 pounds, is much, much more comfortable to play. I grew up playing on big Ramirez guitars, and then getting into my early music career playing on Theorbos that are very, very large. And it's so fantastic to come back to an instrument like this. And Michael has just done a remarkable job recreating, I think, the aesthetic of the original Torres. And I've played quite a few original Torres, and this is probably the best copy I've ever laid hands on, or eyes. Thank you. And if you can believe it, Michael made three of these stunningly beautiful instruments. One for me, one for Steve Longobardi. Steve is a fellow New York paisan, South Shore of Long Island, good friend of a wonderful guitar builder, old colleague of mine, John Monteleone from Islip, New York. Beautiful, once again, beautifully responsive instrument. Those trebles are stunning. It's phenomenal. And one for John Kraus, which will become a left-handed guitar in a very short time. Absolutely fantastic instruments, Michael. Bravo.
Thank you, sir.